Decision. I was little, little shits, I was little, they were like that.
Thank you. always seem to know the way. Then I look at you, that's right, and the world's over.
What I really love is
drawing. This is by graphite, charcoal, and carbon.
And 5 years ago, I just started doing this and went to a lot of workshops, a lot of classes, a lot of training. So something that I was not expected to have. So of course, it gave me more motivation to keep going.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
My name's Beth Amato. I specialize in primarily digital art, but I fuse together elements of traditional mediums with technology. I fuse together the traditional elements, so those are input into the computer, and then I take my computer animation, my computer graphics and photography, and I build all those layers up in programs like After Effects or Photoshop, and then they're layered together into a flat file and they go out to be printed. And then some other like more of a mixed media process, sometimes I put the digital elements output and I apply those to my paintings as well. So it varies based on the particular project that I'm working on at the time.
So are you self-taught or did you go to like art school?
I went to art school. I'm actually, my background, I started, I went for fine arts initially, and then I decided to get my degree in computer animation, and then I started working for a company that did government simulation and video arcade games. Then I transitioned into the advertising industry, and then I ended up in my own studio with my own voice instead of doing someone else's work. An award is a nice recognition, but it's more of a reward when people come in and my work has kind of touched them in some way or inspired them. So the award just kind of validates that for me personally.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Ariel Turgeman. I do leather work. Everything you see is handmade by me right here in Florida. Everything is 100% real leather. I do not use fakes, imitations, faux plastics, or vegan leather. Any of those would be bad for the environment. And all my leather is sourced from the US or Italy. I had a teacher that kind of introduced me to it, and then I just grew into a passion and addiction. I do what's called hand tooling and hand stamping. So you have tools that have a little tiny pattern on it, and you would stamp it and create one seamless pattern together. I also own a large format CO2 laser. So that allows me to do custom engraving for company logos or even graphic design patterns and incorporate it onto leather work.
Heidi B. Gunn. It's a three-dimensional mosaic. It started out, I was just doing the backsplash of my kitchen, and then I did some stepping stones, and then I started doing a few more things, and then my family said, you know, you're making so many things, you should sell them. And then I started going to thrift stores, which I'd never done before, and found all kinds of cool things to break, and then it evolved to this. I did all kinds of arts and crafts as I was a teacher for 30 years, but it was always in the background. It was never my main passion. It's very gratifying because it's difficult to sell things, and you an artist depends on recognition, and it makes you feel good inside that somebody has recognized your work as being valuable. It means the world to me.
Angel Alvarez, illustrator. At least 10 years I've been working as an illustrator, and then this is my fine art that I've been putting together for the last couple of years. I have a master's degree in illustration from the University of Hartford, and then I've also studied with some oil painting mentors over the years, specifically at Miami International Fine Arts Academy with Elkin Canas. What I try to create is imaginative realism. So they're like oil paintings focused on characters, storytelling, and my images are all focused on friendship, adventure, and whimsy. So I like to draw a lot of these anthropomorphic animal characters and just these kind of fantasy characters. I am a published children's book author, and I also have a lot of cartoon drawing division and like kind of like focus as well. My focus is really right now on the fine art and creating more of these kind of original visions and storytelling images that I have with these kind of fantasy characters. Oh, it's awesome. It's been a great experience. This is my first art fair. So it was cool to come out here and then get the award, and it's really helped me give the feel to keep going in this direction. I've got a lot of positive feedback.
I am G-Man.
And I'm Kathy.
And we are G-Man,
G-Man Production, Art for Your Heart.
It's come from, I was always attracted by the heart. And the heart meaning is bring peace, love, and happiness in the world. It's very difficult. And when I begin to do that, I think it was boring a little bit, but I find out the way, many, many ways to create the heart. So, and I think it's a very good thing. And the wood is from my old trees. It gave us a lot of mango before, a lot of good fruit. And it's 60 years old, but over time it was too old, too big, and too weak. So the half of the trees was gone. He even gave us beehives. So we have the beekeeper come and take it out. And 2 years later, I cut down the trees and I start to dry the wood for 4 years in my yard before using it. The wood is, that wood now is not very good for, not good for the furniture, but for art, it's amazing. Like that piece over there, take me a year to complete it. Because I start and I stop and I do something else. But most of the time, take over a month, 2 months, 3 months to finish that.
And then in 2017, he said, I think I'm ready to sell my art professionally. So we started doing art shows, and we came to Pembroke Pines in 2018 and 2019, and we love the team here, we love the vibe here. We feel that his art fits here, and we're at home. We're directly east, we live in Hollywood, and our tree that created these sculptures is from Hollywood, Florida, from the 1950s. That's how old that tree is. We have his atelier, or his studio, is my former garage, which is now turned into an artist's studio, full of shelves and shelves of his wall sculptures, and then his 3D sculptures are in galleries and in our home as well. And then when we take them out to a tent show like this, we bring them all and share them with you.
Make me feel? Incredible. We worked so hard for 7 years now, for 7 years to build it. I don't want to say I never make it one to have a winner win something, but I never ever in my life expect to get the best show ever. And I know here is a beautiful show, beautiful people.
My name is Sureli Mareste, but my artist name is Suki. So I do mixed medium. So basically I use color pencil and acrylic marker for the background and just some ink. Inspired by the Hispanic culture, and especially with the tropical plants. The tropical plants, especially the flowers, which are hibiscus, is from Puerto Rico. And the rest is like almost like Florida plants as well that you can find. And I wanted to do something related of the Hispanic beauty, and just have her resonate with her culture and with nature as well. Just be one with Mother Nature. So the other paintings, I do surrealism, but I also do like a still life and representation, realism. So I have like multiple. So I can do every genre what I want to feel like or want to represent. and send out a message. My future goal for now, I'm in college right now. I'm going to be having my bachelor's degree in fine arts, and I'm thinking either being an art therapist, art teacher, or an illustrator.